ladies and gentlemen, we are back. Oh, did I just lose most of the stuff I just said? Oh, well, anyway. Yeah, we are back at this fight. We are going to win this. We are down one civil, but she'll be back as soon as I can revive her. And, well, yeah, that is because I just didn't want to risk to do the previous fight again. No, I guess I could have taken care of that off screen. But, you know, there's really no guarantee it would turn out to be better than what actually happened. I mean, this is me, after all. Throw strats happen to other people. Usually. Sometimes get in a good move. Oh, hello, you could reach Eldar from there. That was silly of me. Well, yeah, I mean, it's not Fire Emblem, it's not a big deal. But it is a stupid mistake. Stupid mistakes aren't good for you. Ratchet, by the way, I think he's actually a lot of fun to use. But, well, maybe that's just me. You get to see what I mean, hopefully. He does have a few special attacks that will be memorable. I will say nothing more. Especially a rocket punch! Okay, I failed the voice. Yeah, I'm not good at imitating voices, but that's a reasonably good imitation, actually, of what you may be. Yeah, what you may be hearing in the near future. Oh yeah, I have my new pro strats that I'm experimenting with here. This crazy thing called support. So this should be a nice long episode. I don't have many time constraints. Well, at least not any urgent time constraints. So that's all good. I should be able to fit in the entire fight in this little episode in here that we've got going. Actually, let me conserve MP a little and cast a freeze level 1 instead.
Now bear my arctic blast.
Lots of damage. Not a whole lot of MP spent. Eldar might actually kill this one. That'd be cool. And Eldar kills. That I like. Oh, wait. Yeah, there's... I did not give this as a one already? Uh-oh. Oh, right. Well, item management is going to be a bit of an issue in this level fight here. Wait, let me see. Yeah. Never mind. Punch you on the nose. Kabam. Was that even. Oh! Hi. Blaze 3, I should have seen that coming. Well, Irene, you got a pretty good resistance, right? Oh, that's over here. Oh, 5 points resistance to 5% right, resistance to fire. Well, that's apparently not that big of a deal, actually. Okay. Not that I'm complaining. That was Bark.
Rain Thunder!
But yeah, level 3 spells. Yeah, let's let the noise die down first. But yeah, level 3 spells are pretty scary. In, I think it was Shining Force, sort of high about the Game Gear. I played it on the 3S not too long ago. And they introduced this, funny little glitch in that game where freeze level 3 could hit multiple targets with the damage output of a freeze level 4. Enemies with freeze level 3 in that game are fucking terrifying, kid you not. Also, I was kind of expecting Blaze level 3 to do more damage. So that scared me a little more. That added to the fright. But I think we should be good for now. Oh yeah, I keep attacking the hero dude, instead of the people that are actually weak to this. Weak to this type of weapon. Healer experience, always good.
These blessings are upon us.
Now you get support. By a good margin too. Wow. Just here's a novel idea. He supported Grace. Should be pretty tough, right? Yeah, this is stupid, I know. But Obright is tough. He also has the life ring, so. Okay, they seem to be slightly a little tiny bit on the move. Bring it, you guys. Some freeze level 2 with that.
Now bear my arctic blast.
Much money was gained. Can deal with this guy, right?
You're late.
And another special. Eldar is on fire. And holy shit, does he have talent. Oh well. Boom. Got it. Done deal. I really wanted to attack the wing guys with Haywood, but Moonlit Rangers are what they are. Irene took a blaze level 3 to the face. That's unfortunate. Ah. I think she'll survive this though. In before I get murdered with a crit the next turn. You are weak to swords. Great, that suits me just fine.
Ta?
Smack. Oh boy. We are on fire. Huh, now Symbios has a healing item again. It's been some time since the last one. Yeah, putting the white ring on Eldar was probably the wisest thing I've done in this entire run. Yeah, without it, Eldar would have been just dead, like nobody's business right there. Let's heal a bunch of people though. Starting with Irene. Deal yet again. Oh, did I just touch the shoulder button? Oops. Let's see. Grace, we only have an attack magic. She is served best by healing. Okay. Now then. You got murdered. Yeah. Now something weird happened in my nose. I guess you didn't need to know that. Shebang! Just offload some items here onto Symbios. Now, Symbios can actually carry these knives, well, equip himself with them. They do give an extra point of range, as I recall, but I've never really used them myself, and I'm not going to be using them in this playthrough either, so just let me know. I'll leave that for someone else. Like Hayward.
What's that?
I am armed with an apple, by the way. Ooh. good stuff. I wonder if that's the type they call glass apples? I guess it doesn't matter all that much. In the long run, let's see. There we have you guys. Should be okay to bunch up a little while longer. Hi, Wyvern. Come out and play. You know you want to. Did they just start chickening out on me? Not happy with that. That means this fight will take that much longer. Oh, now you're all triggered again. The archers out here to deal with the wyvern. I think I'll need the others, though. Maybe I'll just leave this whole attachment here. Oh, and there we go. Thinking a little. What to do? What to do? Yeah. Hellar can start softening up this. Or Hellar can just do something completely useless. Sorry about that. That was my mistake. Well, this should be good. And good it was. Great. Now there's just all of those people to deal with. I will not put you there. I'll put you there. They are going to attack me the next turn. That I'm sure of. Yeah, this will be interesting at least. Okay. Thank you, Revenge Mace. MVP. I'm gonna have to bench Force, he's just too good. Yeah, a spell dealing 11 points of damage to Albright is not something you should be afraid of, which is why I did not cower in fear. Right there. And now I put LR in a spot where Haywood is blocked from doing anything. GG me. Okay. Where did you want to go with that, actually? And that's a wrap on the High Priest. Let's see, do they have any other healer? No. Okay. No more healing for the enemy. We've done good. Let's see, are you immortal? Yeah. Okay. Get the erect. Oh, ho, ho. Oh. Horst. Well, I mean, he is technically missable, so I don't really have any inclination to leave him out of the force, but goddamn, he's good. Defense and agility. Highly unfortunate. Should be able to crawl? No, not do that. I shall instead do this.
Now bear my Arctic blast!
Maybe I'd best take care of this one with Eldar, yeah. Such a good level up. Look at that. This formation actually reminds me a lot of the Elliot fight in Shining Force 1. Well, I mean, this is a significantly smaller map as well, but... Ah. I hope you saw it as well. Okay, so... Now we heal, I suppose.
His blessings are upon us.
I suppose casting support would negate this whole slow business. Oh, now they are looking a little triggered. That won't do. There, now I finish using my apple. You cannot be bothered by any apple eating sounds again. Well, for the duration of this video at least. What do we need to do? There. Huh. Let's see, you can do freeze. Good. This might be trouble even for Obright. Well, now he's at max hit point, so he will never be in a better position for dealing with all this. All of what, you ask? All of what I ask? Well, I don't know the... like the back of my hand. That's simply the truth. Let's see here. I will utilize my pro strats once more. With the support. Oh yeah, pro strats, definitely. What's happening when you come to open that horse? Okay, just negated the slow spell, did not actually shift his status condition to boosted, supported, something. Okay. Okay. let's do this again. Literally. Boom. And I'll level up on top of it. Horse MVP. I would say it's probably an idea so stupid even I would, I would even do it to put somebody else up in front here right now. Let's see, what happens if I put iron here? Okay, attack. attack the one with the white ring. Perfectly okay by me. Here we go. Freeze level 2 time. Good resistance on my guys there. Yeah. Let's see if we can polish off this mercenary.
Take this.
Okay, done deal. Damage to that one. Oh, hello. Yes. Thank you.
Retire.
No. Not bad. Not bad. I'm happy with that. You don't deal extra damage to Fafhard. Okay. I wonder who does. Oh, boom. Wrecked. You don't? Okay. Smash this one in the way. Literally smash him. Okay. This tag team's just not of this world. Does anyone need healing? Ah, yeah, Haywood should need healing anyway. Okay, I'm going to be doing something intelligent for once. A 43 attack. We have 27 defense. That means 16 damage. Possibly. Huh. What if I move you here and not attack for now?
Spirits, help me.
I've been playing a little Fire Emblem. I think I've said so already. And planning and strategizing like that is sort of a thing that you should do in Fire Emblem. Take into account the enemy's turn, counterattack and stuff. That is, of course, not as big a concern in this game. If I put Irene anywhere near the enemy, he will have a guaranteed 4 target freeze level 2. Not happening. Interesting choice of targets. But now he's down to two castings of Freeze level 2. Bring the pressure.
Take this!
I may even be able to smack him on this turn. Yeah, I'll go for it. There, maybe? Not some big damage. Oh yeah, that's right. Lance types are strong against sword wielders. That would be Sybil. And of course, she's all shit wrecked. Oh, and you're dead. Boom. Finish. Finish me off, Symbios. No way, dude. General Fafhard, Lord Symbios would not kill the man for defending his starving people. I meant to kill Conrad, your father. You would spare my life. This is all due to a false rumor that Conrad and his allies are stealing the wealth of this land for their own use. Once these charges are disproved, and with loyal generals like you, faith in the Republic can be restored. Listening to your words, I believe what you say is true. Non-committal sounds. When I was left in charge of Aspia, I learned of our budget problems. We are too poor to support the populace. A valid concern, Fafhard. One which you should address to Lord Conrad. Reserve judgment until after hearing his reply. I shall do so, Dentaris. I appreciate your considerate gesture. Now that we've just killed everyone else in your army. Just saying. Haha, Toucan, you are too generous, Symbios. If you let a wounded enemy escape, you will return twice as strong. Thus, you invite your own demise. Who are you? Where are you? Damn you, how dare you speak of me so? Let me show you, Lord Symbios, how a wounded enemy should be finished off. Do you understand? You bastard. General Fafhard. Your fiale, High Priest of Bolzone. Oh, I was only doing you a favor by finishing the traitor off. Did I perhaps make the wrong assumption? Just when we'd brought some understanding between us and had a chance for peace. Oh dear, how sad. I seem to have intruded. Well, then I shall be on my way. You are not going that way, good sir. Oh, have I not told you? I have an important appointment. I came all the way to Flagard to meet your father, the noble Lord Conrad. Oh, snap. I heard Symbios. So Conrad is betraying the Republic after all, just as I had suspected. No, that isn't true. You can't trust the words of that lying snake, Fiale. I believe you, Symbios. Please, I'm dying. Promise me to protect the Republic, I beg of you. I shall do so. But thou must learn if my suspicions are real, please. If they are in the name of the Republic, you must execute Conrad. It is the only way. Well, that's not gonna happen on my watch, good sir. Even if you have the most amazing sideburns I've ever seen in a video game. the symbiotes, I trust Lord Conrad, so I'm sure there's no basis to... Of course, there's absolutely no way that you are not obligated to. You don't have to listen to General Fafhard's dying ramblings. Lord Symbios, you intend to uphold your promise to the general? I understand your determination. We shall do the same. We'd be honored to escort you there. Okay, so here we are, in Flagard. Ah, and here you are. If you want me to join you, you'll have to force me. Speaking of which, and by the way, we have a large Mithrin as well. Why wouldn't we? Okay, so apparently there's one more well. But Frank here is a funny little creature. Okay, I'll just do the reviving off camera. See, here's our headquarters. Now, to make Frank join us. Now here's the thing. Doesn't really help the matter that my controller isn't always cooperating with me. It seems to have a less than optimal start button. It's no, it doesn't respond as well as I would want it to. Okay. So this is going to be a lot of fun, but basically when I have pushed him into the headquarters, I will go off screen, off camera, to revive a bunch of people, find a few more items. We have, for example, one potion and two more bits of mithril lying around. Yeah, that's what I will be doing after. After I've successfully bullied Frank into joining the force. He is, judging by the credits, one of the invisible characters. Oh, there you go. You're pushy. I admire that. Alright, you convinced me. I'll join your force. Oh, Frank the Wolf Bearer, not just a wolf. There you go. So, yeah. At the end of the credits, the game will ask you if you succeed in finding some party members. Frank is one of them. A second one we'll see soon. Oh, and here's something you don't see every day. Like I said, peace out. See you in the next video. It'll be great.